Hi, I'm Dave Yates. I'm with Contractor Magazine, and we're here at AHR to look at innovative and new technology. And today I'm here with Shilai from Bosch Thermotechnology, and we want to talk about the new inverter.
Yeah, yes. Bosch is really excited bringing this new innovative product. It's a ducted inverter air-to-air heat pump. So here you can see it's an auto unit. This is a 3-ton unit, but we come in with two sizes, 3-ton and 5-ton. But because it's a modulating an inverter, it actually can slow down to 18,000 BTU. So the range is from 1.5-ton all the way through 5-ton units. So as you can see, is of course, it's an inverter model, so it saves energy. And also, it provides active humidity control. So in a climate where the humidity is high in summer days, you can actually have a better quality control of air. And because it's an inverter, so it actually precisely matches the heating load and cooling load, so you have more comfort and less temperature swings. So overall, more comfort, less energy consumption.
What about the air handler?
Also, it comes with a standard ECM motor, constant air, so it also matches your cool demand and heat demand. And it's got an ECM motor, so it's also highly efficient. And comes with four different sizes. Nominal capacity is 2-ton, 3-ton, 4-ton, and 5-ton. So.
And these two units communicate with each other back and forth,
yes,
so this knows what's speed to run. And I understand you can use any Wi-Fi thermostat that's on the market so that we could have interconnectivity. We could monitor this from our office or from our home, and the consumer can do the same thing. So if they're away on vacation and they're on the way home, they land at the airport, turn the thermostat up or down so that the comfort level is where they want it when they get home. That's fantastic. Shilai, thank you so much. Let's move on to the next product and have a look at what else is on the, slate for up and coming technology.
Okay, we're back with Bosch. And Paul, Midwest Regional Manager for Bosch Thermotechnology. And Paul, what are we looking at here?
What we're looking at our SM model, geothermal heat pump. This is our vertical piece of equipment, really our top of the line product. We've actually had this unit in circulation and out in distribution for about 6 years right now.
Okay.
And we've made some dramatic changes this year from what we had before. Before we had some very simple controls, and what we're finding is out in the market that more people are going to want to use their individual cell phones and more technology. So what we've done is we've changed our individual circuit board down here below. And what that's given us the capability of doing is not only to the contractor to be able to customize this piece of equipment into what fits his application. So we can change CFMs on the motor up here from that circuit board.
So ECM motor, obviously.
ECM motor, yeah. We can actually change the CFMs to accommodate for either a additional ductwork that's maybe the ductwork is not perfect.
And maybe the original installer didn't follow manual D in the process.
Absolutely. You'd hate to think that it happens, but it
I've never seen that out in the field.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've given that opportunity to either ramp the motor up higher than will be the 400 CFMs per standard, or if we necessarily need to do a little bit more dehumidification, our contractors can ramp that down and slow the motor down in heating and in cooling to either get a higher delta T or reduce, have more latent removal.
Nice.
So that's one feature we have. We also have the feature where we can operate the de-superheater. We can change the temperatures. So instead of where a lot of conventional equipment and or our competitors, they will run the de-superheater constantly. Well, what happens when we have lower water temperature coming in from the ground loop? We can actually steal heat from the water heater that we're trying to heat. Because the water heater is actually warmer than the refrigerant temperature. This unit here will constantly sample. When it finds that the water that's in the water heater is warmer than the refrigerant temperature, we'll shut it off. Then, at the same time, if it shuts it off, it'll come back and resample after 15 minutes to see where it is now, so we can maximize the superheater operation.
That's great.
The very next thing that we have is we built that to a two-wire communication. What that gives us the ability to do is operate our new RRC control, which is a fully cell phone capable operation, as long as it's hooked up to the internet, which is a two-wire connection where most thermostats require up to 8 wires, where ours will actually require 2.
Is that shielded twisted pair?
Shield twisted pair.
Yep.
Okay. So very similar. Many times in a retrofit application, there's already 4 wires in the wall. They can hook up a water source heat pump without having a whole new wire. So really? That gives us a lot of advantages over our competitors. And it's a proprietary piece of equipment. That will not only monitor energy usage, it completely communicates with this piece of equipment here on the board. It monitors energy usage, monitors the individual time that everything operates, monitors the temperature, will send it all to an individual phone, and can even calculate how much money it costs you at the same time. So all the individual things that homeowners are going to want, they could start, they could stop their piece of equipment from remote, they could be 1,000 miles away. So they have all that connectivity that people are looking for in this day and age of technology. So we've added those things, but we still kept the product simple. Simple enough for a standard heating air conditioning technician or an installer can still come out and work on this piece of equipment. All the things that they were used to be able to do, they can still do even with the board installed.
Nice.
We've added...
So, for guys like me...
And for on the service tech side, we've also added an added bonus. At any time, while this unit is operating, contractor can go up, turn the Wi-Fi on his tablet or his laptop, walk up to this unit, and communicate with that board without an app. Instantly bring up that board. They can go to communicate with it. They put in a very simple serviceman's code.
Okay.
Once they know that code, they put it in. All the information that circuit board is taking is brought up to the laptop. They can see current temperatures. They can see the pressures. They can see exactly what thermostat inputs are done. And that contractor can see everything that's going on the piece of equipment.
That's nice. That's great.
Live. And it actually goes on a rotation of every 30 seconds. And automatically resets. So he's seeing it live, everything that's going on. So when he has a problem.
Data logging live on the spot.
Data logging live. It gives him two things. First off, he can see what's going on internally without having to add his gauges and a lot of other things. But also, he can take a screenshot, send it right down to tech service. And then the people at tech service see exactly what he's seeing in the field. And it really... shortens up the diagnostic time.
That's great.
So that's from that standpoint, we decided to go this direction, and it helps move us into the future and move our contractors into the future where they want to be.
That's great,
keep
Paul.
Us in the lead.
Thanks a lot. Let's move on to another product. Okay, we're back with Bosch Thermal Technology, and here with Tom, who's with the engineering department. And Tom, what are we looking at here? Could you give us a brief rundown of what we've got?
Sure. What we're looking at is our new SSB boiler model range, which spans from residential up through commercial. This particular boiler we're looking at is 512,000 BTUs, stainless steel down-fired condensing boiler with a thermal efficiency of about 96.8%.
Nice.
Some really unique selling features for our customers, the contractor, would be if we start at the top of the boiler here, we have our exhaust and our air intake adapters. These is typically where you would have to put on an appliance adapter if you were going to use more of a polypropylene or a PVC or CPVC or even stainless. You'd need to apply an adapter to then use that pipe. What we've built into this product is a very unique step-down adapter set, so that way any of those pipe materials can fit in here without any appliance adapter. So this will speed and make the installation go a lot smoother for the contractor. Inside the boiler, we also put a number of features that are necessary. Certainly in a commercial application, we have to meet what's called CSD1 code compliance.
Yeah.
So what that is over here, we have a safety group. And that is a low water cutoff and a manual reset high limit temperature sensor. Now the low water cutoff, if I come over here, we have to prove to an inspector that low water cutoff will function. And so what we have down here is a test and a reset button.
Just like a ground fault interrupter circuit.
Exactly. The LED will come on when we hit the test button. It'll prove to the inspector that it's functioning. We can then hit reset to simply reset that low water cutoff.
That's great.
Now the other thing on the manual reset high limit temperature sensor, we have that tied back to the control. So up on the control, I can simply push two buttons simultaneously, hold it for 10 seconds, and what will come up on the display is that I'm off on my manual reset high limit. So again, we can prove these sensors to an inspector, which are two crucial steps to an installation. And then also the final part of the CSD1 code compliance for commercial boilers is that we have a high and a low gas pressure limit switches. So we have those built in on our 500,000 BTU boilers and up. And those are tied back to the safeties of the control. So if gas pressure were to go too high or too low, they would also isolate and shut down the boiler.
Well, I like the way this is laid out. I like the fact that as an installer, technician, and a designer, that there's room in here for our techs to work without having to take 15 other components to get them out of the way first.
Oh, another feature about that?
I was just going to ask you about this.
This control slides out. So that way you don't have to reach in here. You don't have to work in tight spaces. This control board slides out. Two screws would allow you to take this control board off. And then what you have access to is all your line and low voltage wiring. All wiring will come into the back. And we have knockouts on the left and the right side for easily chasing and securing your wiring through.
That's great.
And then what kind of
weight are we dealing with?
This is our biggest boiler. When it's wet, we're dealing with about 240 pounds, so not very heavy.
Not bad at all.
About 220 when it's dry. So it's simple. It could be a one-person job to bring it in on a dolly.
Nice. I'll tell you what else I like about this. As an older technician, I don't have to get down on the floor to work on anything. Everything's right at normal level where I would be working anyway. So that's great to see. Tom, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate the tour.
You're welcome.